I will introduce the first speaker of this afternoon, Professor Ruby Rodriguez. You're expecting two speakers. Unfortunately, Gunther Ullmann cannot come due to personal reasons. But we're very fortunate to have here Ruby, Professor Ruby Rodriguez from the Universidad de la Frontera in Temuco, Chile. She completed her PhD at Columbia University in 1981 and was president of the Chilean Mathematical Society from 2006 to 2010. Her research area is complex geometry, abelian varieties and group actions. She has a long-standing interest and experience in advancing mathematics and mathematics education in less developed countries, especially in Latin America. Professor Rodriguez, I invite you to present your lecture, and I understand a video, on Mathematics in Chile, a Half Century of Steady Development.
Good afternoon. One of the first things I learned from my advisor a long time ago was that a mathematical lecture would always be in the universal language of mathematics, that is, broken English. So the excuses first for my broken English. And let me start by thanking again the International Mathematical Union, who through the CDC invited the Chilean Mathematical Society to present its case at this event. We felt it was a challenge and an opportunity to share with the world our experience, our successes, and also our failures. We made a widespread call to the Chilean society in general, to mathematicians in particular, to contribute to the preparation of this report. The response was overwhelming. We were very glad. We received lots of data. We had to work very hard to analyze and interpret the data. And we produced a document, a brief document, and a brief video, don't be scared, with all the, that contains mostly what the story, it's not a long story. In fact, as we will see, mathematics in Chile, one could say, started exactly 50 years ago in 1964 when the first Chilean doctor in mathematics returned to the country after completing his degree abroad. And we will see, as I was saying, some of the elements that we believe have influenced the development of mathematics in Chile, and it's very important, as we will also see in the video, the international collaboration. It has been and it continues to be a key element in our development, and so we are again very grateful, thankful for this opportunity, and I now invite you to watch the video. After the, during the poster session outside, we will be giving out the document where we put our report there. So please go talk to us if you have questions or if you want help. We are really willing to do that too. So please, during the poster session, come to our booth. And now for the video, please.
Mathematics in Chile, a half century of steady development. Chile is located on the very tip of South America, occupying a long strip of land between the Andes Mountains and the Pacific Ocean. With almost 800,000 square kilometers of territory, reaching from the northern limits with Peru all the way down to Antarctica, Chile has an incredible variety of climates, ecological diversity, and natural wonders. Situated within the Pacific Ring of Fire and laying atop the Nazca and South American tectonic plates, Chile has a population of around 17 million people and is today one of South America's most stable and prosperous nations. Its unique geography also allows for rich mineral deposits, primarily copper and nitrates, as well as significant agricultural resources. Economic development is based in commodities, including copper exports, which reach about a third of the world's copper supplies. Additionally, agriculture, particularly fruits and wine production, and tourism represent two other major sources of income for the Chilean economy. Biology, and particularly ecology and natural sciences, was the first of the sciences to be developed in Chile. Chemistry and physics soon followed. Although mathematical research in Chile only began to take off in the late 70s, it is growing vigorously and the country is becoming a regional center of mathematical research. Chile's rate of mathematical publications per capita has been increasing sharply. It now doubles that of its nearest Latin American competitor. Nonetheless, this rate is still about a third of that of other developed countries, so that there is ample room for growth and cooperation. Mathematics in Chile before 1960 was limited to that required for the education of professionals. Between the years 1890 and 1930, essential contributions to academic curriculums were done by German mathematicians hired by the Chilean government for this specific purpose, but there was no centralized effort to pursue mathematical research and development. The starting point of Chilean mathematics can perhaps be traced back to 1964, 50 years ago, with the return of the first Chilean mathematician doctorate, Jaime Michelot, after finishing his PhD in the United States. During the 60s, the only options for those who wished to study mathematics in Chile were the Instituto Pedagógico, which specialized in training school teachers, or the schools of engineering of some universities. During this time, a state decision was made to prepare academics in basic sciences for both teaching and research. Several Chilean universities, including the Universidad de Concepción de Chile y Técnica de Estado, created the first programs of bachelor's in science and mathematical engineering. In 1970, reflecting the interest of investigators to pursue further studies in mathematics, locally, the first Master in Mathematics program in Chile was created. The Bachelor's in Academic Mathematics, LAMP for its sigils in Spanish, trained the first generation of graduate mathematicians in Chile.
LAMP for us at the time, this was a very long time ago, 75 in fact, right after, no, 73 actually, right after the military coup in Chile. And the people in charge in LAMP at the time, Jaime Michelot and others, went all along Chile recruiting students for the program. So many of us interested in mathematics went into this program and studied there for about a year, maybe two, and then we left for abroad to pursue PhD studies. The program also attracted many teachers who were teaching at regional universities. And that combination was very important for the development of mathematics in Chile.
Later on, this program grew to also encompass young students who, under fellowships granted by the Ford Foundation, continued their graduate studies abroad.
Input given by LAM, the training that was given there for people who then went back to their own regional universities and taught future professionals and mathematicians in Chile was the one, I want to say the key, but It's probably one of the most important keys for what happened later.
The beginning of the 70s, about 10 Chilean mathematics PhDs had returned to the country after finishing their degrees abroad. In parallel, between 1970 and 1980, about 100 mathematical bachelor degrees were granted in Chile from the newly founded university math departments. Highlighting the interest and commitment of this new generation of Chilean scientists, many of them went on to pursue graduate programs in the US and France. Mathematical research per se in Chile was still only beginning, and the training of upcoming investigators remained in the hands of internationally renowned faculty. In 1973, the military coup d'etat takes place in Chile and universities lost many of their students and academics. In addition, international faculty working in Chile emigrated, and mathematical progress in Chile stalled until the beginning of the 1980s, when a massive return of mathematical doctorates abroad begins. By 1981, there were around 45 Chilean doctors in mathematics working in the country, and a similar number of them remained abroad. A landmark event in the development of Chilean science occurs around this time. In 1981, a national state program for individual competitive grants was created, FONDESID, following the template of the National Science Foundation, NSF, in the US. Currently, in 2014, FONDESID funds 230 grants for the area of mathematics, each for $35,000 annually.
Bueno, la Comisión Nacional de Investigación Científica y Tecnológica, CONICET, financia proyectos de investigación en todas las áreas del conocimiento. Hace más de 45 años que existe esta institución y desde hace 30 años existe en particular un fondo que financia proyectos de investigación individual. Este es el programa FONDESIT. Actualmente en el programa FONDESIT tenemos casi 230 proyectos de investigación. El financiamiento que entrega CONICET a través de sus distintos programas, a través de FONDESIT, a través del financiamiento del Centro de Investigación, a través de las becas de doctorado, a través de estas colaboraciones de pasantía de investigadores extranjeros en Chile o de investigadores chilenos en el extranjero, permitió el desarrollo de las matemáticas en el país.
The first doctorates in mathematics programs in Chile are created at the Universidad Católica, 1972, y Universidad de Chile, 1986. At the same time, Chilean students going abroad for their degrees enlarged the spectrum to other countries such as Germany, Brazil, and Spain. The Chilean Mathematical Society, SOMACHI, began to meet informally in the late 1970s. During those years of political oppression, SOMACHI ensured the continuance of science development in Chile, replacing the frozen state and government initiatives towards science.
Everyone knows that we had a sort of a very dramatic break in our democratic life in 73. So there was a sort of a diaspora at that time, and many researchers continue working abroad.
With this in mind, the Chilean Mathematical Society began to connect and repatriate Chilean mathematicians abroad.
We started to think about the scientific development of the country and to think about policies to develop science in Chile. So, for instance, we applied for funding to United Nations program for a national program for mathematics research. That was one of the first funding we obtained at that time.
In 1981, it organized the first mathematical symposium in Chile, a quadrennial event that remains to this day. SOMACHI also established a schedule of one national and two regional meetings for Chilean mathematicians each year, which now attract participants from neighboring countries such as Argentina, Brazil, Peru, and Bolivia. Throughout the year, SOMACHI has organized teacher training workshops and collaborated with the Chilean government to plan and execute high school curriculums and set higher standards for math teachers. Additionally, SOMACHI has edited textbooks for teacher training and development, and it edits a magazine for high school mathematics teachers. Somachi also organizes the National Mathematics Olympiad, a yearly event meant to discover young talented mathematicians. Aimed at middle and high school students, it offers an amazing opportunity to broaden their scientific and cultural horizons. Since its inception in 1989, the Math Olympiads have attracted about 5,000 students, and among those that have participated, we find renowned professionals of many areas, as well as active mathematicians.
My participation in Mathematical Olympiads was crucial for me. In my family, in the society, it was really impossible to know that this kind of career does exist.
Math Olympiads were my first encounter with math in some sense. I always liked math at school, but I didn't even know there was such a thing as studying math. It was really fantastic meeting all these people who liked doing math the same way I did.
It is difficult to realize that science is possible in a country like Chile or in a third world country. And it was thanks to this possibility to come to the Olympics and to meet other people and to meet the professors that I knew that this was possible. Without the Olympics, I think I wouldn't be a mathematician at all.
And actually now, we have around 40 mathematicians that's coming from this competition. And this is the main, I think, the main result of the Chilean Olympic competition. That is the main result.
Another important landmark in the development of Chilean mathematics was the granting of a triennial award in 1984 by the United Nations Development Programme, PNUD. Assembled by the Chilean mathematical community, the administration of this award was handled by Somachi.
This project started in 1984, supporting the three basic sciences, mathematics, physics, chemistry, and biology, I think.
The PNUD Award funded research fellowships and international mathematician scholars' visits to our country. Most importantly, it set the standards for most future scientific funding research initiatives by assigning the funds based on strict scientific quality.
We decided to support, first of all, the visits of researchers in other countries, to invite people from other countries to make research with somebody here, to complete or to support to improve the libraries and different universities.
The PNUD Award thus had a quantitative and qualitative impact in Chilean mathematics, so much so that Chile entered the International Mathematical Union, IMU, at level 2. The Andes Foundation, a private Chilean institution, strongly supported the development of mathematics in Chile from 1984 to 2004. Its guiding principles set standards for future governmental science funding policies. Its particular consideration towards the Chilean mathematical community meant included supporting doctoral fellowships, internships abroad, and math olympiads, among others. After the public referendum that ended the military dictatorship in 1990, the development of mathematics in the country had a significant acceleration. Several Chilean mathematicians returned, and a number of new initiatives for research funding were initiated by the succeeding governments. There was also a renewed interest from abroad to increase collaboration and to study and work in Chile.
I can see that the mathematics which is being done in Chile is of a very good quality, and they have good interaction, collaboration with both in the American subcontinent and also outside South America, in US and Europe and many other places. So interesting work, both fundamental and applied, is being done by groups of mathematicians in Chile.
The level of mathematics in Chile has developed amazingly since I arrived. When I arrived, it was a very small community, and now in the dynamical systems, in analysis, it's amazingly strong, and it's like they're, especially in analysis, they are world famous. So
yo creo que el crecimiento de la calidad, también el interés de los matemáticos su progreso es simplemente muy bueno. Entonces yo voy a, por ejemplo, voy a comparar, claro, con, en particular con mi país, con mi país nativo, que es más fácil comparar, porque yo normalmente viajo y paso bastante tiempo en Ucrania. Entonces yo puedo destacar que el progreso, por ejemplo, en Chile es bastante mayor.
After the return of democracy in 1990, the Chilean government has funded several scientific research initiatives, including ring grants, funding research projects with a strong collaborative and multidisciplinary core where several groups from different institutions can apply individually or as a consortium. Millennium Science Initiative, funding for the formation of new institutes and research centers in natural and exact sciences. By 1994, Chile has 93 mathematicians with 109 publications that year. The first lines of research are formalized and two doctorate programs are operating out of universities. In 2000, the Center of Mathematical Modeling, CMM, is founded at the University of Chile and is born from the applied mathematical research of a group of investigators at the Department of Mathematical Engineering, funded both by FONDAP and CONCID. Its goal is to develop mathematical modeling and the analysis of complex problems.
How we articulate the relation between the fundamental research we are developing in optimization, stochastic modeling, nonlinear analysis, discrete mathematics, mathematical mechanics, numerical analysis. We connect through labs, small labs of people, professors, engineers, scientists working together.
The key for success for this challenge was the high scientific level of people involved.
El Centro de Modelamiento Matemático se involucra en modelamiento biológico hace más de 10 años. En ese momento, el conocimiento en Chile en bioinformática y modelamiento matemático en genómica, así como en el mundo, estaba partiendo.
At this time as well, research nodes away from the capital of Santiago are developed, including the Universidad de Talca, Universidad Católica de Norte, Universidad Técnica Santa María, Universidad Católica de Valparaíso.
We start from a very naive idea that many people from science get when think about education, that you could go and change it. You know, you certainly feel you know what to do, and you can change it.
At the end of the 90s decade, mathematical research in Chile reaches a peak in production, both in quality and quantity of publications generated. This vibrant, dynamic mathematical community attracts students and investigators from around the world. In 2005, the Chilean Academy of Science, together with the Chilean Scientific Societies, conducted a study of scientific research in Chile and devoted a chapter to mathematics. From the list of active researchers compiled then by the Chilean Academy of Science, one can see that in mathematics, about 28% were trained in the United States, 30% in Europe, 13% in Brazil, and 17% in Chile. At present, there are approximately 350 research mathematicians working in Chile, two for each 100,000 inhabitants. Measured by number of papers indexed in math reviews, over three decades, the Chilean mathematical productivity has risen from zero to almost 500 papers per year. In its 2005 study, the Chilean Academy of Science tried to give a rough measure of mathematical activity in Chile. It counted the yearly number of papers reviewed by the American Mathematical Society, having at least one author based in Chile and divided by the Chilean population. It concluded that in 2003, Chile was producing a yearly total of about 40 mathematical papers per million inhabitants. The corresponding figure for Uruguay, its nearest Latin American competitor under this measure, was 9. For Argentina, it was 7, and for other countries like Mexico or Brazil, the figures were still lower. Typical figures for developed countries are around 60 mathematical publications per million inhabitants. The Chilean government is conscious of this and has greatly increased the number of scholarships available to Chilean students for doctoral studies inside and outside Chile. Increased cooperation with Chile should result in a substantial increase in Chilean graduate students studying at universities abroad.
Un especial agradecimiento a la Unión Matemática Internacional por la oportunidad de mostrar nuestra experiencia una experiencia cuyos detalles no son necesariamente reproducibles. Sin embargo, algunos elementos trascendentales no cuantificables pueden ser considerados por quienes están programando política de desarrollo científico en sus propios países. Quiero primero destacar el espíritu y la disposición de quienes fueron los pioneros en la final de la década de los 60. Ellos tuvieron el máximo desinterés personal, privilegiando el progreso científico con objetividad y alta rigurosidad. Esto se tradujo más tarde en una tradición de cooperación entre instituciones y grupos de investigadores y en una extrema objetividad en el momento de realizar, por ejemplo, asignaciones de fondos. Siempre se privilegió, en este caso, la calidad por sobre la cantidad. Este espíritu fue encarnado e institucionalizado por la Sociedad de Matemática de Chile, que, al igual que los pioneros, siempre privilegió dar oportunidad a los jóvenes estudiantes. Al comienzo de nuestro proceso tuvimos un gran aporte en cooperación internacional. Eso pudo sostener el desarrollo matemático y hoy mantenemos fuertes lazos con la comunidad, con el resto del mundo, para lograr todavía un mayor desarrollo. Sin embargo, creemos que ha llegado el momento para compartir nuestra historia y lo que hemos logrado y cómo lo hemos logrado. Eso nosotros lo queremos poner a disposición de quienes, para quienes les sea útil y puedan seguirla en una cierta medida, y para ello nosotros estaremos dispuestos a la cooperación con ellos.